Hi viewer, and welcome you to Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies, form 3, lesson number 4. The topic is demand and supply. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson objectives. We are going to look at the meaning of supply and also look at the factors that influence the supply. Now, by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to explain the meaning of supply, and number 2, explain the factors that influence the supply. We start by looking at the definition of supply. Supply, it is the quantity of the commodity that sellers are willing and able. Remember, they are supposed to be willing and also able to offer for sale at a particular price in a given period of time. The supply of product does not include any stock that are kept by the producers and not are available or availed to consumers. Anything like hoarding, when you hoard a commodity that is not a supply. Anything that is in the warehouse that is not a supply. So that is the reason as to why we are saying when it comes to supply, it must involve that quantity, that commodity, that the sellers are willing and they are able to offer at a particular price. So you must release it to the consumers. That is when we can refer to it as the supply. For example, as you look from the photograph that we have there, from the picture that we have there, you can be able to see these are sellers. They have released the commodity to those who want to buy, either from outside the country, either from within the country. Anybody who is willing to buy at that price, they have released the commodity. We start by looking at the factors which influence the supply of a commodity. When we talk about those factors that influence the supply of a commodity, one of them, it is the price of the commodity. Now, high prices will encourage more producers to start producing that particular product, thus increasing its supply. So high prices result into high supply of the commodity in the market. So high prices, high supply. Low prices, low supply. So you can get that what happens when it comes to the supply. Number 2, it is the price of cross substitute of the product. An increase in price of a substitute product may make the production of the product to increase, thus increased supply. How does this one take place? When you go to the commodity that where now the substitute price has increased, you are going to get it, demand is going to increase on the other side. So as a result, the producer increases whatever is supplying to the consumer, since the demand is up. Number 3, the prices of factors of production. The prices of factors of production. If the cost of the factor production increases, the costs producing goods and services increases, thus reducing the supply of that commodity. Look at this. When the production cost increases of a commodity, then it means its production will be low. It will be decreased. They are going to be forced to produce very few product. Thus, as a result, resulting to the reducing in supply of the commodity. Number 4, the state of the technology. Advancement in technology result in better methods of production and an increase in the supply. So when we improve the technology in the company, in any farm, you are going to get that the production increases, and these will now result to the increase in supply in the market. Number five, the government policy. This includes the imposition of taxes, subsidies, quotas, and price controls. Now, when I talk about imposing of taxes onto a commodity, it results to the pricing being high, thus reducing the quantity that is being taken to the market. Subsidies. This is the point where now the government pays get some subsidiaries of a commodity, subsidizes a commodity. The price of a commodity, you are going to get that the supply is going to be high since the government is giving some amount of money when it comes, or it is giving some amount of money to the cost of that product. Then we have the quotas. When we talk about the quotas, it is the limit that is given of a certain commodity. It is the one that is supposed to be taken to the market. Then price controls, a situation where the prices are being controlled by the government. Then we have number six, available of input. Shortage of raw materials result to the raw production and slow supply. So a point where now there are no, or it is inadequate raw materials that are readily available for the farm, it is going to produce low products and slow supply. Number seven, future expectations of price change. Where producers expect the prices of goods to increase in the future, they may decide to restrict supply until when the prices go up. This is what is referred to as hoarding of a commodity. They hoard the commodity in order for its price to rise. And this is the reason as to why now you get now the supply is going down in the market during that period of hoarding. Then number eight, we have natural factors. Bad weather like droughts and floods leads to the poor harvest and slow supply of agricultural products. Favorable weather conditions leads to more harvest and small supply. Activity. Indicate by writing a demand or supply whether each of the following factors influence demand or supply of a commodity. Changes in the prices of input, change in taste, changes in technology, changes in outcomes, changes on the price of other related product and preferences. Reference, you can get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 3, third edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us through the SMS to that number. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. You can also Twitter us. Stay tuned to Ability TV. Thank you.